So our family started racing. My grandpa and his brothers are the first ones that started racing for the family. And that was, heavens, about 50 years ago, they started racing for the family name. Before they went to trucks, they started in single-seater buggies and then went to two-seater buggies, and then from there went to trucks, and it's history after that. So that's how it all started for us, and now we're continuing the legacy and trying to make a good and a proud name for our family. I'm a third-generation driver, and I have a little seven-year-old boy that's already sucked into it and going to be, starting the fourth generation. So it's just amazing and a lot of fun that we're able to do this and have been able to do this for as long as we have, as a family, and just having friends that want to come tag along and be part of the family tradition.
To be honest with you, I don't think that we've had a better prep team, from Gilberto and G-Force Dynamics. He's done a fantastic job prepping the truck. He puts his blood, sweat, and tears into the job, and the job shows that he does a really good job, and the truck always performs, fantastic. We're excited to come out and perform and see what we can do for our sponsors and to get ourselves on the podium, hopefully.
Kitchen and I'm whipping up the mollies. Push start button, mijo, I don't need no yavis. And my Theo hit my line and told me that he had to holly. But I made it out the hood, now I'm slanging in the calles.
I put him in my room, like, around everywhere.
Around everywhere?
Everywhere. It was like, my door was like packed. They were like, take them off. No, they're from Baja. Why would I take them off?
Look at the wheel, look at the chain, look at the rings. I swear to God, my shit don't live. This a $400 cut, you been at me for no sin. If this beat just like your girlfriend, then I know I gotta hear sauce.
I have Mitch doing the start, and then I have, we'll do a splash at 170, and then go to 280. And do the driver change and a full fit there, and then try to just bring it to the finish line. I'm just concerned because I changed the gear ratio a lot, and right now it's really aggressive. It really, 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 really feels like a trophy truck.
Yeah, Jeff Geiser down here at the Baja 500, checking out, hanging out here with McNeil Racing, getting ready to go see if we can dominate the spec truck class, but build these trucks. It's a good truck here. It's been proven by Abdali Lopez, and we'll go give it all we can get.
We're here at trying to get our wristbands for the race, and so we're just waiting in line. And we're gonna go through the paperwork, make sure it's all good, and that's about it. But yeah, they're in charge, so we gotta get wristbands to be able to go racing.
We got one driver out that's out pre-running right now. It's Mitchell. He's the one that's going to be starting the race, and he's out doing his homework right now.
Of course, we got you, Kelly, and then Scott McNeil, the return duties.
Yes, sir. And I'm one of the co-drivers. My name is Adam McNeil. And we're excited. We're pumped, ready to go.
We always have, I always have a little bit of nerves before the race. But we did pre-run. We feel confident. The truck's prepped. You can see it here behind us. We're excited. We start 17th, so we'll be pushing pretty hard.
Well, our sponsors that we're really happy with and excited that they're with us is Torco Race Fuels. They've helped us out a whole bunch. Apart from them, we have Raceline. That helps us out quite a bit with our wheels. We have King Shocks. They help us out, and our shocks are working right now, working perfect. Everything's dialed in. We have Maxima Oil that helps us out. The McNeil Racing Inc., which is my cousin, he just redid all of our fiberglass on the truck. Well, it looks awesome.
It looks amazing.
Yes, It looks really good. They've done a really good job. So we're excited about that. G-Force, like I said, he does a great job prepping the truck. Gil's always on top of stuff and making sure we're all good. And Geyser Brothers also helped us out a whole bunch. Our truck is a Geyser truck, and we're looking forward to maybe getting a new one or another one, working out some stuff. So we're excited to have them on board also.
Baja 500, wake up early. We're here. We're ready to go. We're excited. The whole crew's here. We're just getting ready for the last details. Grabbing some ice, some lunches, coffees, and truck's ready. We're just excited to conquer this race and have a good time with everybody.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Please bless that we can have a great race today. That even though if we don't get first, we're just here for a great race. And that if we do get first, we're still having a great race. We're just happy to be here as a whole McNeil family. And with our helpers, Gil and all of his crew. And that we can have a great race and do great and try to get first. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Estamos haciendo nuestro desayuno de campeones.
¿Cuál es el menú de ahora?
Mándeme.
¿Cuál es el menú de ahora?
El menú de ahora son sándwiches, güey, a la francesa, güey. Viene con le papé a la cebolla, güey. Con jamón serrano, güey, traído de España.
When the babies learn to cock and fire back before they even get to live their truth. I think somebody God got me right, cause I don't really look like what I made it through. People from the past wonder how. Somebody tell the realest niggas this shit live inside you too. I keep a bad little vibe, ride or die, shit stand by. I'm not missing if I'm shooting mine. All I ever did was take the risk and learn in real time. How you think I'm up right now, I'm stuck. All in on myself, I treat the movement like an enterprise. Take a look around, you think we made it to the end of time. How you think I'm up right now, I've been living on this.
When we drive by on the highway, can you throw some rags in the window? We don't.
Rags, rags through the window.
10-4, 10-4, 10-4.
Abajo, debajo del asiento mío, pa.
Copy that.
Right as you come out to the road, if you need anything. Coming, the truck is, you gotta go in front of Fox. You gotta go in front of Fox. You'll see us, you'll see us, you'll see us. Go, 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 go. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Right in front of Fox, right in front of Fox. You'll see us, keep straight, straight, straight. Right where Fox took off, right here. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Over here, keep coming, keep coming. Go, 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 go. I can hear you, I can hear you. Double check. We had a little bit of an oil alarm in the truck, so we kind of took over and checked, make sure we had oil in it. There was no leaks, zero leaks. Truck looked great, so the guys
got the confidence back and started pushing again. We took some notes on how much fuel it's taking. Like we said at the beginning, we're trying new stuff, new gears, and we won't know until race day. So now we found out that we're doing less than 2 miles per gallon. So it's gonna change our logistics from here on. We gotta do another splash at Ojos to make it to the finish. But we have everything calculated, and we're really happy for where we're at now. After a long day, not the way we wanted it, but this all makes up for it. You know, we're here in a little town, eating tacos and having the whole crew here and enjoying a little bit of the Baja culture. This place has been here for many, many years. If you can look around, there's stickers everywhere from different people, and all these race teams that come here. And we're just enjoying the food and trying to make the best of the Baja now. That it's Baja one again, one more time, and we're not giving up. We have a big crew behind us, and we're doing this again, and we're coming stronger every single race, and that makes us who we are. But for now, we're gonna enjoy tacos, and but these tacos here, man, I don't know if it's because we're hungry or it's one of the longest days, but every time we come here, they're just amazing. Amazing carne asada tacos. If you take a look over there, they're doing it right at the plate. So it's really good.